Hello, my name is Rainer Hanekamp. This is ng News with the latest updates from the Angular community every week. A new feature will land in Angular 21.1, which might be a surprise for a few developers, which maybe have thought that this is already standard. If we have a service which is provided by a component, so not in root, then that service gets destroyed together with the component. That's not true if that service is provided in the router. Even if you as a user navigate away, the service stays still alive. With Angular 21.1, it will become possible to destroy such services when users navigate away. The PR exists, but it has not been merged yet. No week without signal forms. Mateusz Stefańczyk from House of Angular published a long article on signal forms, adding to the growing list of community content. His article is interesting because he discusses compatForm. This function can work with a signal as well as with a form control or form group. It therefore offers a migration path from existing forms to signal forms. Alex Rickabaugh, tech leader of the Angular framework, was guest at the livestream with Jason Lengstorf. The session consisted of two parts. The first one focused on the underlying concepts and the motivation behind signal forms. The second part moved into live coding. From Alex's perspective, the signal forms are clearly the direction forward. And he also gave a good overview of the three different maturity states which the Angular team uses to mark features.
And so that's really what experimental is for us, is hey, this is not fully baked yet, but we're letting you onto it early because we really value that kind of on the ground feedback about how it's working for real use cases. Then we have developer preview, which is more of like a release, extended release candidate. Like, we think this is feature complete. This could ship as stable, but we want to give developers one more chance to kind of bang on it and see what breaks. If we release an API as stable, we give you kind of, if we are going to make a breaking change to it, we give you two major versions to migrate, both from the time we deprecate something to the time we remove it. Or we have some kind of auto migration for you that will make sure that as you update the code, it kind of follows along.
ng-Glühwein, an Angular conference in Vienna, took place for the third year, and it covered a wide range of topics. All the recordings are already available on YouTube. Push-based, as the organizer contributed three talks. Julian Jandl and Christopher Holder spoke about performance. Adrian Romanski covered accessibility. Thomas Trajan presented modern strategies for dynamic component loading. Michael Hablich gave an AI-focused talk on the DevTools MCP server. And Elise Patrikainen spoke about Angular resources. Members of the Angular team were also present. Mathieu Riegler talked about signal forms, and Alan Egios covered secure management of third-party libraries. Speaking of conferences, ng-Belgrade has announced its revival for next year. The event will take place on May the 7th, and ticket sales are already open. And that's it. I wish you a nice week. Already Merry Christmas, and see you in the next episode for the yearly review.